What's up, everybody? All right, we're gonna do a flight from Las Vegas to Phoenix today. I'm gonna get this cleared up right now, out of the way. I am not an actual pilot, so I'm certainly not type rated to fly a 737-800. So we're gonna do the best we can today. I know I'll miss things, and I'm sure someday a real pilot will watch this and say you did everything wrong. That's fine. We're gonna do the best we can, so let's get started and see if we can have a successful flight into Phoenix today.
Great news, Captain. Your tow's coming.
So we do have live traffic on today. If you see that plane in the background there, that plane is actually on the runway in Las Vegas as we speak. Pretty cool feature in this. Totally free. We're flying with real world weather, wind, clouds, everything's going to be
All
exactly the way
right,
it
looks
is.
like the doors and hatches are closed and we're ready to connect. Welcome aboard, Captain. Tow's connected, bypass bends inserted. Go ahead and kill the parking brake when you're ready to go. Here comes the pushback. Light 'em up.
Go ahead and fire up number two engine first. Waiting for that to hit 25. Fuel. Fire up number one. be coming to life.
Just about done here. Go ahead and set your parking brake. And we're disconnecting the tow. Give me just a moment.
Go ahead. APU.
And we're disconnected. Signal and pin on the left. Take it easy and have a safe flight.
What's up, Gerdo? Hold on, guys, we will be right back. We'll be right back.
caution. Ground to cockpit, plan acknowledged. Call me through the menu when you are ready. Ground to cockpit, tow is driving up.
Okay guys, sorry about that. I had some major difficulties with joysticks as well as children and other things. So we did have to start over a little bit, but we should be on our way soon. I think I got the problem fixed. Like I said again, not a real pilot. Have done some flight school, but certainly nothing in an aircraft of this nature. So this is just for fun, so don't criticize too much. Always looking for helpful hints though. Just waiting for the tow to connect again.
Okay, all doors and hatches are closed. Ready to connect. Tow connected and bypass pin inserted. Release parking brake. Starting pushback.
Gonna be a Boeing. We're in a 737-800. Flying Southwest Airlines. Flight 1421 today. Las Vegas to Phoenix. At 32,000.
Southwest 1421. McCarran International. Altimeter 2976.
McCarran International. Altimeter 2976. Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421, cleared IFR2, Phoenix Sky Harbor International, as filed, maintain, flight level 320, squawk 4700.
Operation complete. Go ahead and set
Southwest
the parking brake.
1421. Cleared IFR2. Phoenix Sky Harbor International has filed. Maintain. Flight level 320. Squawk 4700.
Cleared IFR2. Phoenix Sky Harbor International as filed. Maintain. Flight level 320. Squawk 4700. Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421, runway 8 left, taxi via Golf, Whiskey, Delta, Bravo, Foxtrot, Hotel, hold short of runway 8 left.
Runway 8 left, taxi via Golf, Whiskey, Delta, Bravo, Foxtrot, Hotel, hold short of runway 8 left, Southwest 1421.
Tow is disconnected and bypass pin has been removed. Hand signal on the left. We'll see you next time and have fun up there.
look like anything's coming. We're gonna risk it.
Southwest 1421. Contact tower on 118.75.
Contact tower on 118.75. Southwest 1421. Tower Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421. Fly heading 080, runway 8 left. You're cleared for takeoff.
Fly heading 080, runway 8 left, Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421, contact center on 133.20.
Contact center on 133.20, Southwest 1421. Center, Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421, McCarran International, altimeter 29.76.
McCarran International, altimeter 29.76, Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421. Fly heading 120.
Fly heading 120. Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421. Resume on navigation.
Resume on navigation. Southwest 1421.
Lake Mead. Approaching 10,000. And 10,000 landing lights can come off. This is normally the part where you can start using your electronic devices again, like laptops and iPads. Can tend to get a little boring up here when you don't have a lot to do, but this is part of flying. In real life, I trust me, it's not as boring as it is on a simulator. And Phoenix is a relatively short flight from Las Vegas. It only takes about 40 minutes, 45. Trying to get this white line to match up a little with that purple line right there. It's a little hard sometimes because the wind pushes you off course a little bit. Go ahead and bump the speed up just a little bit. You have to stay under 250, under 10,000, but once you're above 10,000, it's pretty much wide open for you. Increasing the speed is going to lower the nose of the plane a little and not give you that space shuttle takeoff feel. Because we're still climbing at 2,500 feet a minute, regardless of how fast we're going, so that'll just lower the pitch down more. Not a whole lot going on. I'll explain a little bit of the things up here going on. Up here is basically your autopilot. You can have your auto throttle that you can arm and set it to whatever you want. I have it set at 250 knots. Just click the speed button. It's going to hold the speed in the window. So as you can see over here, it's holding 250. You get your heading selector. It's 127 right now. We're at 125. Like I said, the wind's kind of pushing us, so it's holding us there. Same deal, altitude, we're climbing up to 32,000, we're breaking through flight level 20 right now. And we're climbing at 2,500 feet a minute. You can also set it down and descend at a certain amount per minute. 2,000 to 2,500 is pretty comfortable for passengers. Any more than that, it starts to get a little bit too much. You got your landing gear. This indicates what level of flaps you have in. You have your auto brakes for when you land and take off. Throttle quadrant, speed brakes, it's little flaps on top of the wings that come up. Creates drag. Flaps. FMCs, flight management computers. Radio stacks. And that's about it. Really a lot of complicated stuff, but it's not when you learn how to use most of it. Like I said, I don't know how to use everything in here. I know enough to get by. Well, enough to have fun with it, as they say. Coming up to about 24,000 feet. Well above the clouds. See, roughly when you break through about 20,000, 21,000, you're going to start to see the contrails behind the plane. Look up in the sky, you notice white little trails come out of the airplane's engines. That's just snow, water vapor, things like that that are freezing because the temperatures are extremely cold, and that's what gives you the contrails. So that's when you'll start seeing those. Anytime you see a plane with contrails, you know they're at least 20,000 feet up. Fun factoid. Too far. So if we look over here, KPHX, that's just the ICAO code for Phoenix Sky Harbor International. It says we're 26.7 minutes out and 174 nautical miles as the bird flies. It's going to take longer than 26 minutes to be on the ground because you will have to move out for your approach and everything like that, but it gives you a good indication that we're less than a half an hour from the airport. Hope everyone's having a great Monday. I know I had a pretty good one today. Weather's nice here. To wait for monsoon to kick in. Here's our fuel quantity. The left and the right are fuel quantities in the wings times 1,000. The center one's in the center fuselage tank, so we have a total of 19,300 pounds. That's more than enough fuel. That legitimately could fly us from here to New York City without any problem whatsoever. Definitely didn't need that much, but I didn't feel like going through the weight and balance and setting up the fuel and everything. I just let the computer do it for me, because I'm feeling lazy on Mondays. That alarm just means we're 1,000 feet from our altitude setting. 31,000 approaching flight level 320. Valeri Clan, sorry man, looks like another language I don't speak, but welcome. How are you today? We'll bump this up to 275 knots. Well, that's good. This is a Southwest skin 737-800. It's not the ones that have been crashing lately that they grounded, but it's the older version. I've flown a few of these commercial jets on simulators. I prefer 737s over Airbuses. I find them easier to fly for me, but that's just me. Everyone has their own taste. Yeah, it comes standard in X-Plane. You don't have to go out and find it and add it or nothing. It just comes as one of the stock airplanes. There's American Airlines and a couple others. I think there's like five different skins for it. No Airbus planes, so if you like Airbus planes, you have to go out and actually buy those. But that's the only thing I don't like about X-Plane is they don't have a great variety of aircraft. They only have like 10 different planes total. But you can always go out and find them. Kind of like the most boring part right now. Ryanair landing. Man, I'm just gonna try to do a successful landing. I have real weather turned on, so I don't know what I'm gonna get yet when I get to Phoenix. But one way or another, we're going to put the plane on the ground. Yeah, I know. I wish we were there too, Gerdo. Like I said, this is the most boring part of the flight. A lot of times I walk away to go eat and stuff. But 135 nautical miles. They'll probably start talking to us again here in another 50 miles. So. Start telling us to descend, we'll start our final descent into Phoenix, where it's hot as all get out and it doesn't ever seem to rain. Oh yeah, well, it very well could turn into one of those. Like I said, I don't know. I'm not gonna lie, I do crash every now and again. I mean, we're talking about flying a plane that takes over 1500 hours just to be a co-pilot in, so I'm not perfect, but we have a better success rate than a failure rate, so. And again, I don't know what kind of wind we're going to deal with when we get there, but we're going to give it a try. I don't believe so. Like I said, I don't fly planes in this too much anymore, but when I do, it's usually just a 737, so I don't really know what all planes are in there.
Southwest 1421. Descend and maintain. Flight level 250. Southwest 1421. Descend and maintain. Flight level 250.
Descend and maintain. Flight level 250. Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421. Contact center on 127.85.
Contact center on 127.
We're gonna start our initial descent.
Southwest 1421.
Like I said, 737s. All they have is the 800. I think they have an American Airlines, Southwest, KLM. I think there might be a Delta one. I'm not 100% sure on that. Don't quote me on that. But there's only like five different skins, and I've never heard of that one. So you can always go out and get skins, but I haven't had a whole lot of luck with that lately. So. Turn just a little bit more, try to get more on this purple line. So we're starting our initial descent out to 25,000, slow the plane down to 250 knots, increasing altitude to 2,500 feet per minute. It's actually kind of nice, we haven't had any turbulence. It's been a smooth flight the whole way, which makes for happy passengers and flight crew. No, I don't believe I've heard of Ryanair. Sounds like a really low budget airline. Like Allegiant. Thanks for the follow, man. Appreciate it. I have heard of Aer Lingus. So are you from Ireland? That's cool, man. What time is it over there right now? That'd be like early morning, right? Yeah, I figured it'd be a pretty early morning. But yeah, you're already on Tuesday then. So happy Tuesday to you. Happy Monday to everybody over here. We're within 1,000 of 25. We'll kind of just hold here until ATC gives us something. 100 nautical miles out, about 14 minutes from the airport. What's the weather like over there for you? Like rainy and stuff all the time? Dark. Nice. There is not a lot of water out here, is there? Man. I will definitely check that link out as soon as I'm done with this, my man. Looks like a very safe and fun airline. I tell you, I've been on some exciting ones. We're about 78 miles from Sky Harbor and about 12 minutes. I should be getting a call to descend again here not too long. Route you're flying. I'm flying from Las Vegas, Nevada to Phoenix Sky Harbor, and I'm just doing a straight GPS as the crow flies. I'm not flying any different specific legs or anything like that. Just whatever ATC tells me to do. Kind of keeping it simple today. X-Plane, it does have some multiplayer adaptations to it, where you can have pilots and air traffic control, things like that, so you can communicate in real time with other people simulating stuff. But as far as two people playing on the same plane at the same time, I don't believe there's a way to do that yet, which would be kind of cool because there's a lot of things to do in this kind of an aircraft. There's a reason two pilots are in this kind of an aircraft. So sometimes it's hard to move the mouse around and click everything you have to click by yourself, but maybe someday. It'd be kind of cool. Kind of cool to be able to play with another friend who likes to fly and have your own roles. Who play? I didn't know they had a new X-Plane. I know Microsoft Flight Simulator had a new one coming out. Well, that'd be kind of cool to see one come out for a console that's decent. I used to play Flight Simulator X exclusively, and then I jumped over and tried X-Plane because another YouTuber and Twitch person that I was watching played X-Plane, and I thought it was a lot better. Better graphics. Oh, okay, okay. I see what you're saying. So I switched over to it, and I'm actually thoroughly impressed. I think it's a little more realistic than Flight Simulator was, but it's a lot newer, so that's to be expected.
Center, Southwest, 1421.
Southwest, 1421. Descend and maintain, 12000. Wittenberg, Munich, altimeter, 2974.
Descend and maintain, 12000. Wittenberg, Munich, altimeter, 2974. Southwest, 1421.
Got to talking and forgot to start descending. That could be bad, but we should be all right. We're still 49 miles away, going down to 12,000. Could be close to the airport in about 7 minutes. Yeah, it does kind of look like you're going down a bit, but it's really not too bad if you look at it on the horizon. ...209 arrival time for you? Pretty darn close. Yeah, like I said, this is a good approximation of about 6.8 minutes.
Southwest, 1421. Descend and maintain, 8,000. Wittenberg, Munich, altimeter, 2974.
Going down to 8,000. Altimeter's 2974. That's right there, 2974. That's just a standard pressure. It gives you a more accurate and correct reading on your altitude. If you don't have that set right, you might fly into the side of a mountain. So it's important to pay attention to that. And I am descending a little faster than I normally would just because I kind of missed my mark, so. Yeah, one of those things. It's Las Vegas is particularly tricky. They have a lot of mountains right where they're at, and if you don't descend at the correct speed per minute and everything the way you're supposed to, you will crash right into the side of a mountain. I've done it many times. Yeah, it would definitely be like that. Definitely.
Descend and maintain, 8,000, Wittenberg, Munich, altimeter, 2974, southwest, 1421.
Southwest, 1421, fly heading, 150, vectors for the visual, runway, 7, left, descend and maintain, 6,000.
Fly heading, 150, vectors for the visual, runway, 7, left. Descend and maintain, 6,000, southwest, 1421.
Now, taking off in Las Vegas isn't too bad because usually the way you land, you come over those mountains, so the way you take off is away from those mountains, unless the winds change for some reason. So typically you're not taking off towards those mountains, which makes it a lot easier. Feet. Turn the landing lights back on. That is an FAA regulation, if anybody is curious. And I totally understand being tired. I was up for like 5:30 in the morning our time yesterday. Redno737, thank you for the follow, appreciate it. Alright, so we're getting close to 6,000 feet. We haven't been told to do anything else yet. Then we're going to work on getting the airplane slowed down just a little bit. Because right now we're about 300 knots, and that's way too fast. We're going to land at about 145. Give or take. I usually land somewhere between 160 and 140.
Southwest 1421. Fly heading 170. Descend and maintain 3000. Southwest 1421. Fly heading 110.
Fly heading 110. Southwest 1421.
Yeah, we are almost there. We are 12 nautical miles away, about 2 minutes out from the airport.
Southwest 1421. Fly heading 080. Report the field in sight.
Fly heading 080. Report the field in sight. Southwest 1421. Center. Southwest 1421.
Southwest 1421. Clear visual approach. Runway 7 left. Contact tower off. 118.70.
Clear visual approach. Runway 7 left. Contact tower on. 118.70. Southwest 1421. Tower. Southwest 1421.
Putting flaps in, landing gear down. There's Phoenix. Flying the airplane now.
Southwest 1421, runway 7 left. You're cleared to land.
Runway 7 left, Southwest 1421.
little bit windy today. The thing spinning there, it's called trim. So it's going to help me kind of maintain more steady control of the aircraft as I'm coming in.
Sink rate, sink rate, sink rate, sink rate, sink rate, sink rate.
500.
Sink rate, 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 sink rate.
At this point, we're going to retard the aircraft, which means just pull all the power out.
Sink rate, sink rate, sink rate, sink rate.
30, 20, 10.
Oh. That happens every now and again. It's not that big a deal. Just a bounce. Not good, but yeah, it's a little bumpy. Oh. It's really windy here.
Southwest 1421. Hit taxi via 07 Lima Echo 12 Delta 13 Delta Romeo Charlie.
Gate taxi via 07 Lima Echo 12 Delta 13 Delta Romeo Charlie Southwest 1421.
Yeah, a little bit bumpy, but. You know, they say a good landing's anyone you
Southwest,
walk away from.
1421. Contact ground on 119.75.
And a great landing, you can reuse the aircraft. And this is clearly still flyable, so I say that was a pretty great landing. Given the fact it was really, really windy out.
Contact ground on 119.75. Southwest 1421.
Don't know if you've ever been to Phoenix. It's kind of cool, though. We have a road that goes underneath the runway, as you just saw a car over there. So, it's kind of cool. I like that. Cars will go under that. Pretty cool. We're just going to taxi this bad boy up to the gate. It can happen. You'd have to hit really hard though. Sometimes you get a tail strike. The tail of the plane will hit if you flare too much. In all reality, I think I was coming in a little fast still. Yeah, definitely bunny hop. That was more like a kangaroo. Thing hop pretty bad. In real life, they probably never would have put that plane on the ground. They would have just flew around and tried again, but. Oh, you can see Phoenix. So, this is my home airport, as I do live in Arizona, so the reason I choose to come in and out of here, I'm very familiar with this airport. Bunny hop 5 times, wow. Yeah, it all kind of went downhill when I missed that mark to start descending, and I had to descend really fast, which caused the airplane to overspeed and go a little faster than I wanted it to go. But whoa, what are we doing? Got some serious frame drop. Why those are still up. And the front one is a 737-800 mark. So that's pretty much going to do it for us. Just go ahead and set the parking brake. We will kill the engines. Engine one. Come on. Engine 2, powering down. Go ahead and flip all the landing lights off. Fuel pumps. And we'll hit the seatbelt sign. Let them get out. That'll conclude the flight today. Wasn't the best flight, but like I said, we still do have an airplane. So, all in all, I'd say it was fairly successful. We'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye. Yeah, man, it does look pretty interesting of an airline there. What I can say from experience and stuff is sometimes pilots do have to, at certain airports, have harder landings depending on runway length, weather conditions. So if it's particularly a short runway, you're going to have a harder landing because impacting the tires harder into the ground actually drives a lot of that inertia that's going forward and directs it downward. It helps slow the plane down a lot faster. So I don't know if this is all the same airport that they're coming in and out of, and maybe that's why, or maybe they just do have like seriously shitty pilots like what we just had in Phoenix here. But yeah, definitely some hard landings going on there. But appreciate the link, appreciate you watching and following. I'm gonna go ahead and jump off here now, and I'll be back on again later, so check you later, man. Peace.